Iran's president and foreign minister have died after a helicopter they were on crashed. The US State Department says the deaths are unlikely to have an impact on Iran's policies, including their support for Hamas and nuclear weapons production.
After searching for hours in the mountains, Iranian soldiers made it to the crash site on Monday, where a helicopter carrying Iranian President Ebrahim Raisi and the country's foreign minister went down. They found no survivors.
At this point, there is no evidence of foul play. It looks like an accident.
Iranian officials will investigate the crash. And while the country mourns President Raisi's death, analysts say there are many who will not miss him.
Ebrahim Raisi was considered the butcher of Iran, the butcher of Tehran by Iranians for his personal role in one of the greatest mass executions of political prisoners.
While Raisi's death is a significant loss, it's not likely to change current policy inside Iran. But it does raise questions about the country's future.
The supreme leader, Ayatollah Ali Khamenei, who sets the policy for Iran. And certainly Raisi was a protege and a potential successor to the supreme leader, but he's not determining the policy.
Iran is known for backing militant proxy groups like Hamas and Hezbollah. And recently, the regime has cracked down on women's rights, and there's been a massive surge in government-backed executions. The U.S. State Department says those policies will likely continue.
We're going to just trade this terrorist for the next terrorist that the Ayatollahs are going to install.
Iran's Vice President Mohammad Mokhber will serve as interim president. Iranian law requires new elections be held within 50 days. In Washington, Rebecca Castor, Fox News.